I just want to know why.
At a Senate hearing on Monday, a visibly irked Senator Cynthia Villar lashed out at officials of the Departments of Justice and Agriculture after she learned.
Wala kayong na-example, Ms. Kisa, ngayon. Sasabihin ko sa inyo, bakit? Bakit? What's wrong with you?
Villar's temper began flaring up after officials from the DOJ failed to give a thorough report on the personalities linked to the alleged garlic, onion, and rice cartel in the country.
It's still for issuance ng resolution. Hindi po natin makita kung... Ang pagkakaintindi ko po mayroon ng draft, but since it's confidential po kasi...
Napunta ka dito, ito ang topic, tapos wala kang alam. Ano ba yun? Kaya ka siguro pinapunta dito para sabihin sa amin wala kang alam.
Villar asked for the report last month to find out why the 127,000 metric tons of garlic demand in the country is only met by 50,000 metric tons of imported garlic supply and 9,000 metric tons of local garlic production. She believes the imbalance is caused by smuggling. Villar later showed a copy of the DOJ's annex report of affiliated garlic importers carrying the names of supposed members of the cartel. One of the names she mentioned is a certain Leia Cruz.
DOJ sent the annex of that report of the competition office of DOJ, and we have a list here of yung Kelea plus yung kanyang tawag nila is mga affiliated importers. If you see the affiliated importers, marami dito same name, different corporations. At mayayaman to, yung iba dito kilala ko eh.
Before ending the hearing, the senator also issued challenges to both the Agriculture and Justice Departments.
DOJ, magdemanda ka naman kahit isa para bigyan naman natin ng sample para matakot-takot naman at wala namang katakot-takot. At ikaw, Philippine Competition Commission, i-penalize mo, minimum fine sa cartel is 100 million. Pagpainin mo si Leia Cruz para matakot-takot. Large-scale agricultural smuggling is economic sabotage and non-bailable. Ibig sabihin, pending. If for example, hindi sila ma-prosecute, dapat nakakulong sila ngayon.
I will talk to the lawyers of the department and we will issue an order temporarily because we cannot permanently ban them unless there is a valid legal ground.
Villar estimates illegal traders can earn around 100 pesos per kilo of overpriced garlic or onion, or at least 1 billion pesos a month. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.